And I forgot to record this lecture. Now I started recording. Okay. Recording of these lectures, it will be available on BodhiTree. Right. Now the next, it is the skeletal system which we were discussing, that is about the study of bones and joints. So bones are made up of cells, protein fibers and minerals. So the skeleton, it acts as a scaffold by providing support and protection of the soft tissues. Scaffold means, see, when the building repairing takes place in civil engineering, you see outside of the building, these workers, they erect a structure of bamboos, right? Bamboos are made of some iron, so that they climb on that. In Marathi, we call it a sangara. Okay, so they use it. They use that structure for climbing, repairing purpose like that. So it is something similar to that. That is the functionality of our skeleton. So actually, skeleton supports the protection for the soft tissues that make up the rest of the body. So it provides the attachment points for muscles to allow movements at the joint points. So that is the skeletal system. Then the muscular system, which is related to body muscles. So all these are actually the medical terms. Just to have a little exposure to this terminology, that's why I have listed here. The muscular system, it is in vertebrates, is controlled through nervous system. Each and everything, it is controlled through nervous systems and can be completely autonomous. Together with the skeletal systems, it forms the musculoskeletal system, which is responsible for movement of the human body. Okay, digestive systems, I will not explain all these things because these are common things, right? And we do not want to study all those things in details. So I'll just list here. Digestive systems, which takes care of food, convert the main functionality is convert food into energy and basic nutrients to feed the entire body. Okay. Then endocrine system. So this endocrine system, it includes glands and hormones. So it is related to the hormones which are secreted through our various glands. So that is actually this endocrine system. Then exocrine system. So this consists of organs like skin, hair, nails, and exocrine glands. See, one of the functionality of this exocrine system is to throw out the unwanted material from the body. Okay. Then lymphatic system, that is related to the immune, and okay, it is closely related to systems that share several organs and physiological functions. Lymphatic function systems means the system which throw out, which removes the toxics or unwanted material from the body, that is the lymphatic system. Okay. And this lymphatic system and the immune system, they work together. So immune system works to keep these harmful agents out of the body and attacks those that manage to enter. Then urine system. So the main organ related to urine system is the kidneys, which acts as the filter. Okay. Then reproductive system to reproduce the organs. Okay. So this is just introduction of all different types of systems. Okay. Now slowly we'll come to the point, because we are not actually the doctors, medical doctors. So our purpose is to provide the instruments and give some analysis about the signals which are produced by our body. Okay. But to work with the instruments, you should have some basic knowledge and the terminology, you should be aware of that. So that was the purpose for listing all those things. Okay. Now, here I have listed some instruments, the classification of biomedical instruments. Okay. Different instruments which are employed in biomedical applications. Now, first column, these are the blood instruments related to the blood. Second column, the instruments related to heart. Okay, so I'll just introduce you. Blood pressure meter, you all are aware of this. Doctors, when you go to doctor, they use some band here and they pump air and measure the pressure. Okay, then blood pH meter. That is to find out the pH of the blood, whether it is acidic, whether the blood is having acidic nature or alkaline nature. Then blood flow meter, to measure the blood flow. Blood cell counter, count the cells in the blood. Calorie meter, it is related to the energy. Then spectra photometer. Now here, this is actually some optical instrument where some light is incident, and based on the reflected wavelengths, some conclusions are drawn based on that spectrum. So that's why the name spectra photometer. Then flame photometer, this is actually, it studies the related to the movement of the sodium and potassium ions. So that is called as the flame photometer. Then digital BP meter, blood pressure, to measure digital blood pressure digitally. Then about the instruments which are used for heart, ECG, which is used to, that is the electrocardiograph, which is used to measure the signals, you know, ECG like this. Okay. Then pacemaker. This pacemaker, it is actually a oscillator. Now, you know, our heart, it works on some electrical signal, right? So heart, it is actually a pump, hydraulic pump, which is responsible for blood flow. It carries out the pumping action of the heart. Now this happens with the help of contraction and expansion of the heart muscles. Right. Now, to initiate this contraction and expansion, some electrical signals are provided for the heart. Now, naturally, these electrical signals are generated by the heart itself. So later on, we will study inside the heart, there is one part called as the SA node. SA node. So this SA node is actually responsible for generating the pulses which are required for oscillator, which are required to trigger the contraction or expansion of the heart. So this basically works as an oscillator. Okay, now because of some defects in the heart, malfunctioning of the heart, if this SA node stops working, then in that case there is no electrical signal is available for the heart to initiate contraction and expansion. Then in that case the external device is placed inside the heart, and that device, it is called as pacemaker. So this pacemaker, it is actually a oscillator. This pacemaker, it is a oscillator which generates some pulses, and these pulses are provided or supplied to the heart, which initiates its expansion and contraction. So this oscillator, it works on a battery, and by using operation, this pacemaker is installed inside the heart, near the heart, by operation. Okay, and it had some battery life, 10 years, 12 years, like that. So after 10 years, then the patient again is to be operated for to replace the battery. So this is the electrical device. If our heart does not generate the necessary electrical signals, then this external oscillator is installed inside our body. So that is the pacemaker. Then defibrillator. Okay, so this defibrillator, this is again an electronic equipment, which, now sometimes what happens, for our heart, if it is not functioning normally, if there is any malfunction, and the doctors, they know that by giving a small shock, that means by providing small electrical signal externally, the heart can be activated. So for that purpose, this defibrillator is used. So it gives actually a small electric shock. So that is the defibrillator. Then heart lung machine. Bedside monitor, plethysmograph, then electronic stethoscope, you know these things, and phonocardiograph. So this phonocardiograph, this is actually a measurement of all the sounds related to heart. Because when the heart contracts and expands, it produces different types of sounds. So recording of all those sounds happens with the help of this phonocardiograph. So this is just some of the instruments related to blood and heart. Okay. Then some more instruments, EEG, related to brain, it is the EEG, that is electroencephalograph. So electroencephalograph, this is the instrument which records the electrical activities of the brain. Some electrodes are placed on the brain at various locations. So this we will study in detail later. I think fourth unit is given, devoted to this electroencephalograph. So actually, when we carry out different activities, the brain, it generates different types of signals. Right. Now, the electrical activity of the this brain, it is different when we are performing different activities. For example, if you are active, if you are running or you are doing some activity, the electrical signal produced by the brain, it will be different. If you are sleeping, still brain is working, but that electrical signal generated in that case, it will be different. So by analyzing EEG, this EEG signal, you can find, you can get the doctors, they can find out different types of conclusions about the functioning of the brains, or if there are any disorders like that. Okay. Then this tomograph, it is, you might have seen, there are some instruments which take the slices, right? If there is a three-dimensional object, then taking slices of those three-dimensional objects, so that is tomography. Then muscle instruments. Now the electrical signal related to muscles, it is EMG, that is electromyograph. So similar to EEG, there is a the electrical signal which is generated by our muscles is called as EMG, that is electromyograph. For recording electrical activities of muscles. Then we have muscle stimulator. So some electrical equipment which gives some impulses to stimulate muscles externally. Then these are the instruments related to kidney, dialysis, you might have heard this. Then lithotripsy. So this lithotripsy, it is actually a technique by using this either through some laser beam or through some electrical signal, the stones which are accumulated inside our kidney, those stones are destroyed, or they are broken into smaller pieces. So that is lithotripsy. Basically used for, if somebody is having kidney stone problem, then to dissolve those stones, this is the technique which is used. Then ear instruments, the audiometer, hearing aid, eye instruments, oculometer, and the aid for blind. Okay. Similarly, for lung instruments, there is a spirometer. So this spirometer, it measures the amount, the capacity of the person to inhale air and exhale the air. That is the volume, how much volume of air particular person can inhale or exhale. Okay. I think today we will stop here. This remaining part we will discuss in the next lecture. Okay, all of you are given attendance in the chat box. Please give your attendance in the chat box. Mention your roll number in the chat box. From that I will count your attendance. Okay, so if you are given attendance, then you can leave the class.